Good evening, folks. It's Diamond with the Oppenheimer Ranch Project, bringing you a grand solar minimum update Wednesday, July 18th, 12:12 a.m. Mountain Time 2018. You're about to see Sakurajima explode just hours ago. This is the 40th explosion in 50 days. And this one goes to about 15,000 feet, which is halfway to the stratospheric boundary. Now, the atmosphere ends around 33,000 feet at the mid-latitudes, but it varies. It can be as high as 45,000 feet, as low as 29,000 feet. The stratospheric atmospheric boundary varies. And several of these eruptions have slightly penetrated that boundary. This one is nowhere near it at 15,000 feet. We're waiting for our VEI 6 or 7 to completely break through that boundary, and that would be an eruption to 50,000 feet, which would penetrate the atmospheric stratospheric boundary and in place particulates up in the stratosphere, which could last for years. With increased cosmic rays and cloud nucleation, that does not bode well. You can see how the upper part of the eruption right now is larger than the lower part. And in a high eruption to 50,000 feet, this plume would be placed into the stratosphere, causing rapid global cooling, which we're expecting anyway. But to add insult to injury, if a major eruption like this occurs, it's doom and gloom. So we'll be waiting for it. Give him a thumbs up here at Volcano YT, doing a great job over there. Now, what am I talking about? Cosmic ray increase. You're living, the cosmic rays have reached a new maximum, folks. As you sit here, and for the next several years, cosmic rays are reaching uncharted territories as far as modern man is concerned. Oh, that's no good. Now, we're going to be talking about a connection found between Kitashima and Sakurajima, which we just looked at exploding Saku just moments ago. We'll get to it. Mohave Fire. Amazing video of a firenado becoming a waterspout. I'm sure you guys saw this. If you didn't, we're probably not going to be able to have the bandwidth. This is the 10th take on this video tonight. It's been rough. But basically, this fire moves to the right here. Forms a waterspout here that has such strength that it starts ejecting trees from the fire into the water here while people boat by. Totally insane firestorm. Now, similar wildfire happened here in the San Juan Wilderness about 5-7 years ago that was 10,000 times this size. And it was actually sucking up 140-foot trees that were 36-inch diameter at the base into the sky and dropping them miles away. And they pulled all firefighters off that fire. So that's just the fury of Mother Nature. Come check it out, the Firenado in Mojave. Heads up, extraordinary record rainfall drenches Reagan National Airport, 2.63 inches in 42 minutes as predicted, as we reach a new cosmic ray maximum. Record rainfall events like 2.5 inches in 40 minutes are going to be the norm. That's true. There have been no measurable rain at Reagan National Airport. They just set another record. 19 days, including the first 16 days of July, without a single drip of rain. Then 42 minutes, the heavens unloaded 2.63 inches as intense thunderstorms barreled through the region. Now, I've been here 40 years, said airport observer Nick Parrell. Airport observer? Is that a job? And I've never had that. Yes, you haven't. Tuscaloosa area breaks rain record for July. Totally fluxed in Tuscaloosa, getting up to 4.39 inches in a single day in July. Heads up, 11.25 inches of rain. June rainfall breaks records in Yellowknife. Environment Canada says the city's wettest June in the past 76 years, thanks to cosmic ray flux. Whew. Let's go back 76 years. Where are we? Oh, we're back here when cosmic ray flux was high. Thank you, Svensmark, for picking up what we're putting down. And for putting out the papers continuously for over a decade until finally someone listened. 99 killed in landslides triggered by torrential rain, worst toll in 30 years. Take a look at this. Tokyo, as many as 99 people were killed and two remain missing following 863 landslides in 31 prefectures. Holy mackerel. Boom! Heads up. Check out the hail coming down today in Pisano, Italy. We're talking baseball size hail. If you don't have a helmet on, you don't have a life. Now, I've jumped out of many airplanes and terminal velocity is around 175 miles per hour as you fall to your death towards Earth. You can change your position and vector and go head down and accelerate over 200 miles per hour easily in that position by reducing your drag. But if you're just dropping in French frog, you're doing about 173 miles per hour, just like these ice balls are doing. And if they hit your head at that speed, oh, God forbid, get a helmet. Now, we've been reporting on increased hail size for several months. We have reports globally of massive hail everywhere, and this is what leads to that crop loss and famine. We're going to get to that shortly while we read some reports from the little ice age in Europe. We're going to get to that in a minute. Bear with me. I hope this doesn't shut down. Meta tsunami floods islands of Mallorca and Menorca in Spain. Now, this is just wacky weather caused by strange wind patterns pushing meters of water up into Mallorca and Menorca in Spain. And we'll be looking for more of this wacky weather moving forward. Let's talk about a frozen hose in Urala. Firefighters deal with a frozen hose at firehouse. Yes, it's true. In frosty minus 10 degrees, you can't fight fires that well. Firefighters were stopped in their tracks when the water main at Queen Street burst, flooding the road with black ice that matters. Without the pressure from the water main, water inside the firefighter's hose froze solid. It's pretty rare, and it was certainly very cold, said Commander Wayne Zekon. Boom! Yeah, it was cold. The bomb said it wasn't going to be. You do the math. UK weather, 2018 could be our hottest summer on record. Could be. Probably not, but it's certainly the driest, and that doesn't bode well for the carrot crisis, which hasn't been this dry since 61 when they murdered Kennedy. Who knows when that was? Weather warning, 3 weeks without sunspots leaves experts fearing big freeze. They're just getting the memo. The sun has now gone almost 21 days without spots. And now experts fear that we're headed to a solar minimum? This is obviously for retards. Or people that just woke up and learned how to read yesterday and they have no information or data. We've all seen the glowing green sun and it's amazing. Whew. I love that. Whew. Look at that. Man, that is amazing. Scientists have been frantically monitoring the sun as lack of sunspots confirms the worst of our planet. Experts report that we are now on our 20th day without a spot, according to this guy, Dean Pesnell. The longest since 2019. What will we ever do? Now, what these people fail to realize is that for the next 2 years, we are going to be dropping back through Dalton minimum levels into the Maunder minimum area. And even if we come out into a cycle 25, we are still back in the Maunder minimum. And cycle 26 is going to put us back in the Maunder minimum. And if you want to know what happened back then, there is a lot of information out on it, and none of it is good. Global unrest, famine, crop loss, boom! We've got some Caribbean activity with the 4.3 kicking off in the Dominican Republic just moments ago. Only other quake of note today is a 5.0 in Mexico, and we're waiting on a large explosion to be kicking off in Kilauea in the next 1 to 2 hours following up this 3.2, which is typically how it ensues. Now, space weather has returned to more moderate levels at KP3. Which is why you can see a lot less seismic activity globally. Deep subterranean connection found between Kirishima and Sakurajima. Now, the Kirishima is a group of calderas, all stratocone, very dangerous, including Shinmodake. And we've been reporting on Sakurajima for months, exploding with regularity almost daily. We just showed you today's explosion. Now, this stratocone is not the actual volcano. This circle represents the most recent large explosion from this caldera. And these two areas are connected, which contain over 30 volcanoes between them in this region I'm circling. So we could even potentially see a VEI 8 in this size coming from this region, or one of these larger calderas in awakening. And they've also shown us a major caldera of epic proportions, the largest on Earth, offshore here of Japan, with magma actively entering the chamber. Little ice age in Europe. Check out these grain price spikes. They go on for several years here through the Dalton minimum. Here's a huge spike for decades in the little ice age. And here's the more complete, finer grained, detailed data of the rye prices in Germany through time. Now, if you play the commodities market, these are spike. Our modern grand minimum spike is going to begin now. It's going to start peaking next fall, 2019. And I don't know that because I'm a soothsayer. I'm simply watching what's happening with crop loss and failure. I look at the solar models, the statistical analysis that comes out of Armstrong Economics, and the facts that we're looking at here, the historical grain price spikes. So you can go long on grain next year and make it out big. But it doesn't bode well for humanity because death and famine in Scotland, here you can see it spiking in multi-decadal scales in and out. Just like the grain spike. So there's periods of drought and deluge, hail and destruction and prosperity, and then drought and famine. It's not all one way. There is no linear climate. There is no linear time scale. Everything is cyclic. Look at the data. Here's a spike in 16, a spike in 18, and we're going to get a spike in the 2000s. It's a repetitive spike. Now here, let's read some amazing information. This gives you impacts on forests, impacts on health, impacts on the economics. Now there is not all bust. Not all the economic impacts are bad. If you're going to get into rigid greenhouses, you're going to be a millionaire. Trust me, if you sell preparedness products, you're going to be a millionaire. A bug out bag. Think outside the box. Teach people how to grow food. English fishermen benefited by the southern movement of fish. Conditions during the Little Ice Age led to many causes of social unrest. The winter of 1709 killed many people in France. The winter of 1739 was also bad. Not all winters are bad. There was a 20-year lull between bad winters, two solar cycles. Reports of the occurrence of cattle raids in the lowlands. In England, the effect of starvation and the poor conditions of the country encouraged men to enlist in the War of the Roses. People thought to be witches were the worst to suffer because they were thought to be making weather, which means that we're going to kill the weather modifiers, the powers that be. We're going to go after the government, the liars. Extensive witch hunts took place during the most severe years of the Little Ice Age. And I imagine the same thing. All government buildings will be lit on fire during this current ice age. One of the history's most notorious quotes might have been due in part to a rare, extremely warm period. So all you people claiming why it's so warm in England, it just followed a cold beast from the east winter. Now, the extremely warm period during the Little Ice Age in northern France in 1788, after an unusually bad winter, May, June, and July were excessively hot. There was a massive drought, which caused grain to shrivel, just like the carrot crisis happening now. And on July 13th, just at harvest time, a severe hailstorm destroyed what little crops were left. From that bad harvest of 1788 came the bread riots of 1789, which led to Marie Antoinette's remark, "Let them eat cake." And then the storming of the Bastille. So what you're looking at is the historic timeline, which says that you have 1.5 years until we storm the Bastille. Come check out this paper for more amazing details. Yes. Astronomers discover 12 new moons orbiting Jupiter, bringing the total to 4,863,000,000,000 moons. What do you think, Denzel? I know, boom, there's a hell ton of moons. That's a hell of a lot of moons. Now, Jupiter is a failed sun, if you don't know. It's a gas giant, same as Saturn and Uranus, or Uranus, depending on what you're looking at. But just look at how many moons are here, kids. This could be its own solar system. The Galilean moons, the prograde group, and the retrograde group. They all spin in different directions. What we know about the solar system and the universe is a complete farce. What we've been told in school is a complete lie. There is no accretionary disks. There is catastrophic events through an electrical universe. Now, these are basically orbitals similar to an atom, where these objects are being held electromagnetically in these bands, which is why they can rotate in different directions, which is why they don't all collide, which is why we don't have very many collisions ever, because we are in an electric universe, not a gravitational universe. The gravitational theory is dead. Gravity is not a constant. It varies based on electrical potential. Whew. Designing and building a solar sunspace or greenhouse coming out in April of 1988. This will introduce you to an attached solar greenhouse. Many of you are asking for designs, and here they are, starting in 1988. It talks about thermal mass and everything you need to know. A more modern version is the passive solar greenhouse, a do-it-yourself design guide, second edition. This is coming from Verge Permaculture. Come check it out. It's free. If you want to know about 7,000 plus plants, come to the 7,000 plus plant page. You just put your plant in. You could search Latin names, common names, family, habitat, edible, medicinal, other uses, on and on. If you just want to look for a blood purifier or birthing aid, an infertility drug, anti-dandruff, you just click on it and you go look at the plants. It's an amazing resource from Plants for a Future, pfaf.org. Yes, I agree. Archaeologists unearthed the earliest evidence of fish fermentation up in Sweden. Jagar Svenska. They have uncovered the remains of 9,200-year-old storage for fermented fish. Now, this can only be done if there is modern civilization with large groups of people living in communities. There'd be no other reason. And this is placing civilization 9,200 years ago, right after we came out of the last ice age. So clearly all of the history that you know is a complete farce, and you should be purging your brain of it now. As Pan-STARRS comet S3 is rocked by a new outburst as it's about to make perigee very soon here. It's going to make its closest approach on August 14th, I believe. Closest approach to Earth happens August 7th, and the closest to the sun is the 14th. And this baby is lighting up, and it could reach magnitude 3 according to this article, but I'm going to say it could be negative 10. This is just the first of many electrical phenomenon that you're going to witness as we descend into this grand minimum that are going to make everyone on this planet question everything about what we know. This is evidence of cosmic catastrophe in the past. This is a little fragment of a cosmic catastrophe that we're well aware of, and the information is being hidden from you. Now, if Piers Corbin can make it up, stay up late to 3 a.m., he'll be on the radio program tomorrow night. Freedomslips.com, Studio A, 10 p.m. to midnight East Coast time. And we're going to be talking about his method using the sun and why he is the most successful predictor of weather in Europe to date. Come out, check out weatheraction.com, and we'll have Piers Corbin in a two-hour interview loaded up on the channel in just a week. Guys, I hope you got something out of the video. Just remember, the earth is where you live, and that's why you need to grow your own food. It allows you to save money, save time, save resources, improve your health. Think about it. If you're not planting a seed, you're wasting time. Cosmic rays have reached a new maximum. According to our friend Svensmark, that leads to increased cloud nucleation, atmospheric compression, record rainfall globally, and it's only going to increase for several more years before it dips off for a short respite and increases again to new unprecedented territory. This is going to happen for your entire lifetime. The time is now to start preparing to survive and thrive in the future. Find like-minded people. Plant a seed tomorrow. Be safe.